What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Don't Starve Reign of Giants DLC with Wigfrid. And me, Clarity. Yeah, that's a little bit of a weird intro, but whatever. You guys probably are wondering, how are we going to take on this jerk of a monster? I'm sorry, I'm just trying to figure out how to sort through things here. I'm always doing this at the wrong time. Should probably fuel this back up and then turn it on, just in case my stuff does go and burn. So, when we left off in the last episode, let me get myself a little... Okay, here we go. When we left off in the last episode, we were attacked by the dragonfly, which is the giant of summer. He burns everything in his path and just eats it all up. He's a big jerk. He killed us. Yeah, we took him into the swamp here, around here area, and it got nighttime, and then we started to get a little bit too warm, and we tried to deal with him using the swamp creatures, but he ultimately ended up killing us. Luckily, we did have a touchstone up there. You can tell by the wood pattern that's up there. Unfortunately, we don't have... I should probably not store that in there, actually, because that'll... really hurt that. Okay, unfortunately, we didn't have any, like, backup stuff, and we didn't have good enough stuff to deal with him in the first place. So, what I'm going to do before I go and deal with this menace is just kind of prepare myself, because he won't come to me. Like, he's off the screen. I don't think he's loaded or anything like that. He's not coming to me. So I think it would be best for me to just prepare myself, and that's what I'm going to do. Because I mean, I've got 44 health, I've got low sanity, and he does decrease your sanity from being around him, and a bunch of other things that I just have to deal with before I am able to just like deal with a mob like that. So the first thing that we're gonna need to deal with here is probably our sanity and our health. Before we go and start making some armaments. Now, there is a little bit of base maintenance that I also need to do, but I'll do that off camera. So, for now, what I think I'm going to do for my health is, just kind of make a couple healing salves, because we do have some rocks now. I didn't when I first died, because I ended up, doing something silly and took all of the rocks with me, when I died over here. So when you spawn with like two or three rocks, and I use those to make myself a battle helm over anything else, because battle helm requires some rocks and some stuff like that. Okay, I am looking for some ashes. Do I have any ashes on me? Uh-oh, I think I took all of my ashes with me as well. Well, that sucks. well, this is not going so well. Alright, so we're gonna put that back. Alright, I'm gonna deal with my health and stuff and my sanity. I'm probably going to just eat some jerky, because jerky increases your health and your sanity. And, I'll be right back. I'm gonna also make myself a couple more battle helms and some log suits, and I'll be right back. Alright, so welcome back, guys. I just got myself a little bit of charcoal by burning some stuff up, and I got myself a little bit of ashes, so I'm going to use that to make myself some... where is it? Some healing salve. And I'm also... we only need a little bit of ashes. We need two ashes for that. Whoops, forgot about that. So yeah, we had enough to make ourselves a little bit of healing salve. After eating a little bit more jerky, I've got myself up pretty high in health. Not as high as I could be, because this is half health right here. But yeah, so one of the things that I wanted to make sure that I had before I went out and fought him was another boomerang. Like, I wanted some boomerangs. So in order for the boomerangs, we're going to need some boards. I have the silk for it, and I just got the charcoal. So I'm going to have to wait a little bit and then get myself a bit more logs. We're going to need some boards, so we're going to need 8 logs. And I'll be right back once I have those boomerangs made, and we'll go out and fight ourselves a dragonfly. Alright, guys, Operation Kill a Dragon is a go. As you can see, I am well prepared this time to deal with this guy. He caught me a little bit off guard the last time, and I really didn't know how to deal with him. I didn't expect him to actually come to me. I thought I would have to go to him. From what I read on the wiki, he really likes birch nut trees, so I thought maybe he would spawn in this area here, just like the moose goose did. But it turns out that he spawned up here, and that was because I moved away from my base. As soon as I hear some growling or some hissing or anything like that, I normally run away from my base because I don't want anything to get burned. So, we are in the swamplands here. I'm gonna see if my stuff is still around. If it is, I'm gonna try and lure the guy away from my stuff. Ooh, let's actually get a tentacle spike, because those things are pretty amazing. Alright. I also made myself an extra helmet and an extra log suit, because, yeah, there we go, there's our stuff. Okay, well, where is this bastard? Where is he? He should be around here somewhere. He's giant! So, you know, he wouldn't be that hard to find. I don't seem to... I don't see him, and I don't hear him. Did he disappear after he killed me? I don't know. He does revert back into his passive self after killing a hostile mob. Well. Uh-oh. If he's gone, this is gonna be a really boring episode. I was really hoping to kill him. Darn. Well, we're gonna get some hounds anyways. Yeah, where is he? That is not cool. That is not cool, bro. You don't kill me and then run away. That is not cool. He did burn up a lot of trees, by the way. That's kind of his thing. He likes to burn things. Alright, so we're gonna get attacked by a bunch of hounds right now. We are unfortunately not in a very good spot to deal with them. Where did he go? I don't think he's here anymore. I think he's gone. Okay, you, enough. Enough out of you. Enough out of you. You have no idea what I've been through. Come on. Enough is enough. Come on. I'm not going in that. They're burning themselves. This is awesome. Yeah, by the way, I can two-shot hounds. Doesn't bother me. Alright, so, pick up some... Ugh, man. Okay, well, it seems as though we don't have this guy anymore. He's not here anymore. This is weird. Did he roam off somewhere, or does he just, like, despawn when you're not around? Either way, that would be a little annoying. Alright, well, I'm gonna head back to base. I'm gonna give a little bit of a lookout for him. If I find him, I'll be back, but if I don't, well, you know, whatever, I'm just gonna head back to base and do something else, because I'm not gonna wait around for him. Welcome back, guys. So yeah, I gave it a little bit of a look-see. Could not find him anywhere in the swamp. That is where I left him off. I'm gonna have to check around, like, some birch nut trees and stuff like that, but I think he might have just, like, despawned for the rest of the summertime, because summer is coming to an end here in the next, like... 4 or 5 days, it should be transitioning to autumn, so he might have, like, despawned on me, which sucks really big balls, because I don't think I would have been able to fight him again anyways, but it still would have been nice to have shown you guys a little bit of that. Oh man, first guy to kill us, first death, that sucks a lot. You little jerk. He's such a big jerk. Alright, Glommer Poop, you're gonna go into this right there. Glommer is amazing for that, by the way, keeping those alive. Alright, let's throw that in. I'm gonna do a little bit of organization, and then I'm also going to move all of our tooth traps here, and move them over to our base right here, because I don't think we need this area anymore. I don't know why I built it so freaking far away. But, yeah, so I'm just gonna build that out around here, and I'm also gonna build up a bit of my base maybe today. I don't know. We're gonna see. I will be right back once I'm a little bit more prepared. Alright guys, welcome back. I did a little bit of exploring. Still couldn't find the guy. I didn't get my all of my stuff back just yet because it wasn't really high on my priority list. As you can tell, it is raining right now. That's the other thing I wanted to mention. That means that fall is a-comin', so yeah, we've got some autumn on the go. Autumn isn't really all that scary to me, to be honest. It's one of the easier times to deal with. The only thing that can really be troublesome during autumn time is preparing for winter and the bear-ger, or bear and badger put together. By the way, last night, was a full moon, so I want to stay the hell away from my pigs right now, because they will wreck my face if it becomes night again. So, yeah, we might actually end up killing our pigs right now so that they don't have a chance of coming over and destroying my base, because that would just be annoying. As you can see, I gathered up the tooth traps from our little encampment over there. I'm gonna leave it for now, like the walls up there, until we need like a lot of, until we are completely out of some stones, and then I'll go back over there and refarm it up. But for now, I think it's perfectly fine to leave it as is. On the docket today, though, is to make ourselves some more tooth traps, because we have a lot, and I do mean a lot of hound's teeth. Holy cow. So I'm just going to make myself a buttload of tooth traps and just fill out the area with them for now. So let's see. We've got 10 teeth. We've got 14 wood. Yeah, that should be enough. And then we just need 10 rope. There we go. And then we just go into here and make a bunch of tooth traps. Alright, so I am going to place those, and I'll be right back once I'm done. Alright, so, yeah. Alright, so this is what I've got so far. It's a nice little track up there. We might actually farm up some guys today. I'm going to go kill some of my pigs so that they don't attack me when the night comes out. Because it's pretty easy to kill pigs when you have a Wigfrid who has advanced damage stats, and she gains health and sanity back for attacking pigs. And plus, you know, my pigs are here for me to harvest, so might as well harvest them. Alright, I think I might also make another pig house here sometime soon, after this next full moon. So now that we've got our pigs out of the way, we don't have to worry about them coming back to haunt us type thing, because on the full moon, if you guys don't remember, all pigs turn into werepigs, and werepigs are not fun pigs. They are hairy, they're nasty, they're basically the equivalent of a werewolf, as you would expect by the name, which can be rather gruesome to deal with. I don't even think my tooth traps would have stopped them. To be quite honest, they are really ridiculous, and having them so close to base can be a little bit of a pain in the butt. And that's why I did put them a little bit far away, but as you could see, like, one of the pigs was wandering close to my base, and I wanted to make sure that that didn't happen anymore. I had to give him a firm talking to. He's like, no, I'm gonna keep on going, and I'm like, okay, well, if you do that, I'm gonna have to, you know, do some things. And he's like, well, you do whatever you need to do, man, and that's what I did. Also, all of our gear that we use to, like, all of our extra gear, I just put it into this backpack over here. So that's all of the gear that we had ready to fight the dragonfly with. It would have looked nasty if I just left it on the ground, not to mention also a little bit of a pain in the butt to pick up if I ever needed to go into battle. So I think what we're gonna do now is just take a little bit of a breather. And I'm gonna eat some beef jerky. Oh yeah, that's delicious. Okay, I really don't need to eat the jerky, to be honest, because I can just eat small animals. So I think what we're gonna do for the rest of this episode is just kind of do a little bit of base building, and I'm gonna need to do a little bit of resource harvesting. But doing that during the full moon is a little bit of a pain in the butt, so I'll be right back once the full moon has decided to go away. Welcome back, guys. Yeah, I said I was gonna do a little bit of resource gathering. When I said little, I was kind of lying. As you can see, I just cleared out the entirety of this area. There's like two rocks left to go, but I think we're just gonna leave them behind for now. And I'm just gonna throw this on the ground. I gathered myself a ton of rocks, a ton of gold, a ton of flint, and a ton of niter. Main reason for that is because I was really low on the rocks, and I would like to expand my base a little bit. For the rest of the episode, I think that's what we're going to do, is kind of spend a little bit on base design, and maybe even try and get ourselves some beefalo in a cage. So we'll see about that. I'm gonna head back and put all of this stuff into my base here for a moment, and I'll be right back. Welcome back, guys and girls. Yeah, I'm just waiting on a little bit of food here. There we go. Oh, yes. Stuff that in your face. Oh, deliciousness. Alright, so today we're going to be doing something a little bit different than what I have ever done before. We are going to try and get ourselves some beefalo. You might be wondering, how the heck do you lure the beefalo away? I mean, like, my beefalo are all the way over here, and I'm talking about capturing them? Like, what? Capturing them over there would be kind of useless to me, because I'd have to walk the same distance, and there's no reason of capturing your beefalo in the first place then. Well, there is something called the beefalo horn. Basically, whenever you play this, you'll have up to 5 or so adult beefalo follow you. The children will not follow you, but they will follow their parents if they are called. So you can get some children beefalo following you as well. Yeah, so you basically play the horn. It takes about, it has 10 uses, I think. These guys angry with me? No. Okay, I needed to make sure. I think they're only angry in springtime now, to be honest. There we go. Alright, so I'm just going to kind of kite them around. We have a lot of beefalo over here, by the way. Just wanted to mention that. So I think I'm going to play the beefalo horn. This is going to be the first time I've ever used one of these, so. Okay, we got good few of them coming after us. So they'll basically follow you around until until they catch up to you, I think? Maybe? I have no idea. This is, like I said, this is something I haven't tried before. So we're gonna check it out. Do I have to be within, like, screen distance of them? No, it seems like they are following me nonetheless. I think they have to be on this biome, but I'm not entirely sure. I would like them, like, around here-ish, so that I could just lock them between my farm and my base, which would be really nice, because then I could have some poop farms going on the go. And that's why I have the stone wall, by the way. So they basically, once you play the horn, 5 of them, up to 5, I should say, adults will just follow you around until they catch up to you, and then they'll stay at the spot that they found you at and just kind of wander around in that area. So, yeah, it can be used to kind of lure them into a little bit of a place. I probably should have built the place before I decided to lure them in, because it's probably going to mess with my design. I'm not sure if they're able to get up to here. I don't know. I'm going to experiment a little bit, because I do have, like, quite a lot of uses out of this beefalo horn. So I wouldn't mind having, like, a room right here with beefalo in it, or, like, right around here-ish. I don't know, maybe a little bit more locked off. With beefalo in it, because that would be really useful to me. So I'm just gonna, because then I can also use it to connect my farm here. There we go. Okay, you guys, right here. There you go. Oh, there we go. Now I don't need all of them, but they seem to be. Yeah, I'm gonna have to build this room and then try and get them back in, aren't I? Oh, darn. Okay, and this rabbit hole is probably gonna have to go. I don't know. Let's build it. Oh, I can't do that because of the rabbit hole, can I? Oh, I can't do that. Rabbit hole. Darn it! Alright, so I think I'm gonna have to destroy rabbit hole. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, that's so lame. Okay, whatever. It's for the better. It's for the greater good. Come on. Alright, so I'm gonna build the room for the beefalo here. I do have a lot of rocks, but I don't know if I have enough. Okay, there we go. And then I think I want to leave one open. And then just start building around here. And then I'll lure them in. I think I'm going to destroy a block up over there so that I have an area to get in and out. And then I'll lure the beefalo in through this area and then walk out through there and then block this off or something. I don't know. We're gonna test it out. I'm gonna have to wait through the night though, so I'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. We have a little bit of a beefalo base on the go. You can't really see it on the map because for some odd reason walls don't really show up. I'm not sure what the reason is for that. Maybe it's because like it would really clutter it up. But here's our beefalo that we had following us before, so we're just gonna play our horn again. Okay, I hope they don't have red bums, because I thought I saw one of them with a red ass, and that would mean some trouble for me, but we should be okay. Alright, come on now, you smelly bastards. Come on. Let me bring you to a life imprisonment. Nah, they'll be perfectly fine. I mean, it's going to be exactly the same as if they were just out in the wild. The only difference is I'm not going to use them and abuse them as much. Because, I mean, the other ones, I don't really care if they die now, because I'll have these guys. So then I'll be using those guys as defense all the time, anytime hounds come out and about. It'll be nice to have. Anytime we have a tree, it would be nice. Stuff like that. I am not a nice person. Let's just get that straight. And on the go. Okay, I don't want these guys to lose. Come on, conga line! Conga... Oh, conga line to prison. Come on. It's not every day you hear that line. Oh, come on. No, 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 no. Oh! Okay, they are angry. Come on. Good jerk. Okay, so they are in heat, it seems. That's gonna make this a little bit more of a pain in the butt. Alright, come on. In you go. In you go. In you go. There we go. Alright. They shouldn't be able to get out through there, but they can. Oh crap, this is not going to be a good idea. Oh crap. What did I just do? What did I do? Oh no, this is not good. Oh no, I have a little bit of a hole up there because I thought I would be able to get through it and they wouldn't. I guess that's changed. I guess they are a little bit bigger than you would expect. Okay, stop that. Thank you. Alright, so I'm going to plug this one up. Oh no, don't repair. Alright, alright, he's angry with me. But, you know what? Oh no, 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 no. Come on. No. You little jerk. Come on. Aww. Okay, well, I've got a little bit of stuff that I need to do and look up, so I'm gonna redesign this room a little bit better, and I'll be right back once I, capture some beefalo. Alright guys, so I think I figured out what was my problem. I was basically just leaving one wall length open, but what you want to do is you want to put one wall on a diagonal so that you have like this little tiny gap for you and you alone to be able to get through. So there are some other creatures that are really easy to, like, that can get through that, so. But I don't think the beefalo can. Oh, what the heck? Oh, I guess the beefalo triggered some of my tooth traps. Oh, well that's a bit of a pain in the butt. Alright, well, I'm gonna wait until, morning, and then we are going to try this whole beefalo thing yet again, and, hopefully this time it'll go a little bit better for us. I think I'm gonna leave just, like, a one wide gap here. Yeah, there we go. And then once I get them in there, I'll just, like, loop around or something. I don't know, I might have to wait until mating season is over, because right now they do have the red butts, which means that they are going to attack me if I am around. So, that might be a bit of a pain in the butt. It might be useful at the same time, so I don't know. We'll try it again the next day. Welcome back, guys! It is yet another morning! The beefalo have destroyed pretty much everything in their path, because they are monsters. Does a butterfly? No. Butterfly wing does not apparently count as meat, even though you have to destroy a butterfly in order to do so. A warrior would not do this, I suppose. Do you guys still have red butts? I think so. Yep. They do. Well, this is annoying. Stop! Stop! Stop, I say. Okay, we're gonna try and get them into the pen this time. Okay, let's see. Come on, let's follow me. Hey, everybody, I got some hot beefalo babies over this way. Come on, come on. Good time, no? Good time, come on. You know you want a little bit of a beefalo ass. Yeah, you want some, don't you? You got a red butt. Alright, come on, let's go. I'm gonna pick up some grass on the way, yes, yes. Okay, enough of that voice. Alright, so, come on, you stupid buggash. Yeah, this is kind of the reason why I wanted to bring them over to my base in the first place, is because it's so long of a walk to get over there. The other reason being is, like, having beefalo right next to your base is kind of nice. Because, like, a little bit of protection goes a long way. Okay, we're gonna test this out. Hopefully they can't fit through the crack over here. Which I accidentally repaired those walls up. Okay, let's see. And eventually we'll have all of our walls will be like too thick. Alright, so they can fit through the one by one, the one block there. Okay. Can you get through here? I don't know, that guy got pissed. Okay. They're trying to go this way. Which is... Oh, they can! Darn it! Oh, no, 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 this is not good. No, come on. Go away, go away. Let me build the wall. Oh, they pooped where I want to build the wall! Darn it. Once they attack something, they get annoyed with me. They get bored with me. So I'll have to keep them away if I want to keep them. Alright, so, No idea how I'm going to do this. Alright, I'll just block this off for now, and we'll come up with something better later on, I guess? I don't know how to keep them from doing things. Come on, guys, look, see, I still got a horn. Aren't I cool? Yeah, I'm cool. Come on. I'm cool. I swear I'm cool. You go back in your hole. I don't want the Beefalo getting attracted by you. Alright, this is going to be a bit of a pain in the butt. I think what I'm going to do is bring them over to this corner here, and then hopefully they don't poop on the hole. Bring them over to this corner here, and then try and like get around them and then build the wall on the outside. I don't know. Oh, this is not going well for me. Oh, I can't build the wall. Oh, darn it. Oh, this is not good. This is not good. They're getting out. And they're attacking everything. Okay. Come on, you buggers. I can tank Beefalo for days, man. Come on. Come back in the freaking wall. I didn't expect their buddies to actually come to me as well, which was weird. Okay. 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 Are your buddies in here yet? Yes, they are. Sweet. Ow. Ow, 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 ow. Oh, I locked myself in with a Beefalo! Uh-oh. Okay, they're trying to leave, which is all good. Can I hammer this without them? I don't know. I'm gonna try and make some stones here. And then build myself a wall. So I have a replacement. Because I think as soon as I break this down, they're gonna try coming out this way. Yep. That's what I thought. I can't do that. There we go. Sweet! Stay away. You're a jerk. Alright, so we got ourselves Beefalo! Yes! Thank you guys so much for watching me fail horribly at getting Beefalo. Yeah. If you haven't noticed, we have hit the wrapping up point, so once again, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching me fail half as much as I did laughing at myself fail. Until next time. Bye.